Welcome back, everyone. We're going to take a look at a new battery by Wattcycle. This is their smart mini Bluetooth 100 amp hour 12 volt LiFePO4 battery. This has a BMS that can discharge up to 100 amps, high protection cutoff for temperature, and low protection cutoff for temperature. The battery comes with your standard hardware here, some caps and a couple sets of screws, and comes with two very comprehensive manuals. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna read through some of the specs in this manual for you. All right, if we check out the book here, it shows 100 amps continuous maximum charging and 100 amp continuous maximum discharging with a standard of 20. It's got the overcharge discharge protection there, voltage release protection, short circuit supported, and it has high temp and low temp cutoff is what it says, which is pretty good for a battery in this price range. We'll check out some more of this instruction manual here. All right, there's your specs. It's M8 terminal sizes. It's about 9 inches by 5.5 deep, so not too big. 6,000 cycles at 80% DOD. You can do 4P, 4S. This is the mini smart, so it does have Bluetooth. It's IP67, and it does have some fire certifications on this plastic case here. So not too bad at all. It gives you charging and discharging times there. All right, we got the Wattcycle battery hooked up to our LiPo charger, and we just wanted to show you something real quick that we haven't noticed with many manufacturers. They included longer bolts here so that you can add in more stuff onto the terminals there. I've noticed in a lot of manufacturers, they only ship you the one size bolts, and if you stack up a few lugs, it becomes an issue. So kudos to Wattcycle for including multiple pieces of hardware. We have it down here on the Bluetooth here. We're gonna hook it up, and then we're gonna plug in the charger here to show you. As you can see, it shows individual cell levels. We'll get down here and zoom in for you. There you go. And now we're gonna plug it in and see how it works. All right, we are charging at 30 amps, if you see right there. And it is charging now. And all the cells here, that's the voltage difference, is 0.006. All the cells are about the same, 43%, and it is charging. One cycle. Oh, we had a disconnect. Maybe because it's charging or it's low power right now. And there we are. We're charging, it shows all the voltage, the current, 400 watts going in. So we're gonna leave this for a while and charge and then come back and try a discharge test on it. Just wanted to show another feature. You can actually turn the charging off with that switch. And as you see there, the battery now shows fully charged to the charger when it's actually not. So we'll turn that off. And then we'll wait a second and see if it clicks on. If not, we'll hit the discharge switch, which we're gonna do. We'll hit the discharge switch, successfully set, and it should start charging now. There it goes. All right, we have the kilometer watt turned on. We're gonna turn the heat gun on high. As you can see there, it's draining down some power. It's pulling 8 amps of AC, or about 700 watts or so at 61 hertz. That's what we're gonna watch. We're looking for 1.25 on there. We'll connect up the app and show you exactly what's going on here. As you can see, we're discharging at about 66 amps from the battery, 800 or so watts. We're just gonna let this thing go and see how much we can get out of here. All right, we're coming up on the end there, 5% of the battery left. And we got 1.03 kilowatts out. That's pretty good. All right, it just disconnected at 1.03 kilowatt hours. That is 1,030 watt hours out of 1,250 watt hours, I believe is what this holds. So yeah, it's about a 20% conversion loss, a little less than 20%. It's absolutely amazing. This battery is good to go.